Metro Boomin want some more, nigga. What's going on, guys? So in this video, I'm going to show you guys how I now do my new wash and go since my hair is absolutely shorter now, which is obvious. So first I put leave-in conditioner all over my hair. Since my hair is shorter, I don't really focus on sections unless I'm styling. So I started off with freshly washed hair. I shampooed my edges and let the shampoo run throughout my hair, and then I conditioned and put in some leave-in conditioner. And to apply the leave-in conditioner, now I just literally drag the product throughout my hair, try to get as many spots as I can, but I'm not trying to be too precise when I apply the leave-in conditioner. I'm also going to be showing you my go-to style that I've been doing a lot recently. Now I'm sectioning my hair. I section it in half and put away that side, and then I deal with this section, and then I break this section in half again. But now, according to the clip, I parted my front first, then I broke that section in half. And you guys already know my hair has to be really wet to do a wash and go, so I'm spraying my hair with water and to also reactivate the leave-in conditioner, and I slightly detangle. I then applied hair butter, or it's kind of like a moisturizer, to my hair, making sure that my hair is saturated with the product, because this will be my moisturizer, so I want to make sure that my hair is thoroughly moisturized. As you saw, I detangled my fingers first, then I'm using a Denman brush. This has made my wash and go process so much easier, and since my hair is shorter, this is the best way for me to make my curls pop and to detangle. It's so much easier. I have a less frizz and it's just bomb. Then I add a styler in the form of a jelly or gel with a sticky consistency. You guys know the drill. Then a few more passes with the Denman brush. Quick tip, I focus on my ends first, then I go up to my roots when I use any styling tool. You guys see how juicy that looks? So my hair has a tendency to fall forward. Pin that away, and now I'm going to focus on the part in the front. So basically I just put some rubber bands, do some sections, and put some rubber bands in my hair. I mean, simple. I do that whole moisturizing process and style up process over again because I didn't do that in the beginning. I wrap the rubber bands around 3 to 4 times and then pull and brush it out with the Denman brush. And this is how crazy my hair looks when it's all out like that, but I'm gonna show you guys what I do to give my hair more volume at the top and to give it more of the shape, but I kind of cut it wrong, but yeah, let's go with this. So I brush the front parts upwards instead of back or forward because this is the way I want my hair to dry, and for the front part where the rubber bands are, I pin them back, like right near the rubber band. I put some pins there so that my hair can stay out of my face and it can add to the shape. And I was completely out of focus here, but I also shake my hair and play with my roots to give it more volume. I'm showing you guys what my hair looks like with all the product in it. And you know, this is me getting ready to leave the house and having people come up to me telling me I have white stuff in my hair. I mean, okay. Now this is after 4 or 5 hours. I mean, I went about with my day and my hair is technically dry, but not dry because my roots are kind of still wet, but my hair is dry. So I usually have to play around with the shape to get the shape that I like. I'm expressing how much I love the Denman brush for this length right now. Guys, lifesaver.